Steve Morse Band, you either know what the music's about or you don't. And this way it works a lot better for, well, you know, there's no image beforehand. With the name Dixie Dregs, people formed an image before they heard the music, and that hurt us. We were doing, you know, apparently music quite different from the name Dixie Dregs, from the image that it conjured up.
How does that music differ from the Dregs?
Our music differs from the Dregs. More guitar-oriented, of course, and a little bit more rock-oriented, naturally, since there's more guitars. The two go hand-in-hand, despite the synthesizer generation. The rock still has quite a bit of its sound from the guitar. And I'd say there's a little bit more acoustic guitar prep. Well, yeah, more acoustic guitar possibilities now.
Can you work in all of your background? Because I understand your background goes from jazz to classical to everything, as well as rock and roll.
Well, yeah. Well, a lot of people that have been playing a long time have played many different styles, and that's one of the most fun things about being a musician is playing the different styles. And one different thing about our group is we try and do different styles during the course of a concert, or even in an album, and that makes it hard to pigeonhole what we're doing, of course.
You've been voted best guitar player, overall guitar player, by Guitar Player magazine for 3 years in a row. Well, I'd be interested in knowing, when you were coming up, when you were starting, first picked up the guitar, who was the guitar player that influenced you most?
Like everyone my age, I think it was probably the Beatles. I started with pop, Beatles, Rolling Stones.
But any particular guitar player?
Not one in particular.
No.
Well, maybe Chuck Berry. You know, when I heard that sound, I said that I was playing a Fender, and I said, "How can I get that sound?" And I didn't know about the different sounds that different guitars make, so I went way out of my way to get an amplifier to get that sound.
You've also gone way out of your way in a way to keep a low profile for many years. Like I said, you're a guitar player's guitar player. And why have you suddenly decided to make videos?
Well, it's almost like a band that makes it big suddenly deciding to make it big. Everybody tries to do what they can do, and it was just finally the right time, because videos became, well, as you know, they're so commonplace and important that nowadays it's practically a necessity to attempt one, at least.
No, thank you, Steve. What we're going to do is we're going to take a bit of a break right now, okay? And then what we're going to do is come back and have Steve play some guitar for us, right? That's right. Tell us in that particular video as well, none other than Earl Slick. Now, we've got a sizzling guitarist with us, too. That's Steve Morse, of the Steve Morse Band. And Steve is going to play a little bit, look for us. But first, I want to ask you that both of your videos are instrumental pieces. And like a lot of your music has been instrumental for over the years. Do you think that in today's pop listener, as far as the pop audience is concerned, unlike in the late 60s, that there's a place for, like, instrumentals, instrumental videos on the scene?
Well, I think particularly due to the cloning of lots of different things in the 80s, that it's more important than ever to have an identity. So I think instrumental music has definitely got a place, just as long as it's done well and it is presented in a way that people can grab onto it. Because entertainment is entertainment in any time, in any media, practically.
How do you feel about lyrics?
I like a lot of lyrics. My problem is I can't sing them or write them very consistently. So I try to do what I do best.
And I'm interested in knowing about conceptual videos and what you feel about that.
I think the marriage of video and music is the strongest form of media that we have. And I'd like to get more into it myself. I mean, not just saying, okay, here's a tune, let's add a video to it. Let's conceive both at once. I mean, that's what it's all ultimately heading towards. And I'd really like to be part of that.
Well, one thing the audience should understand, if you've never seen Mr. Morse play, you're going to see a little touch of it in just a second here, because I'm going to ask you to do that for us. And remember, this man is voted the best overall guitar player by Guitar Player magazine for 82, 83, and 84. Would you please just give us a little taste?
Uh-oh. Okay.
Thank you. Dixie Dregs. He takes his new record. It is called The Introduction. Listen to how this man is such a fine player. You can hear it right now. But also remember, Guitar Player Magazine voted him the number one guitarist overall, 82, 83, and 84. Thank you, Steve, for coming by.
Thank you. Bye.
He'll be performing at Nassau Coliseum.
Little Scottish flavor to it. Who are the two young men playing with you?
That's Van Romaine on drums, Dave LaRue on bass. Pros.
Okay. That had a Scottish flavor to it.
Yeah, kind of a Celtic influence, in my opinion. I wrote it that way because, to me, that's a lot of the roots of bluegrass music, which I dearly love. And I thought I'd give you something a little different there.
What was that called?
It's called Highland Wedding, and it's from a new album on MCA. Oh, my. Sorry.
It's fine.
Sorry.
You have
Thanks.
A new album on MCA?
Yes.
We're happy to promote that.
Thanks.
Okay. This is the phone-in segment? Okay, you can call and talk to Lacey J. Dalton, T. Graham Brown, or you can talk to this talented guitar player, Steve Morse. And also our trivia question, which T. came up with, was who had the original recording of Hot Rod Lincoln? That's for a pair of boots, Acme boots.
That Ralph knows the answer to.
Well, yeah, but I'm not going to give him the answer yet. Okay. Tell me your name, where you're calling from, and tell me to whom you would like to speak. Hello there.
Hello there.
Hello there. Who's this?
Joyce Johnson.
Hi, Joyce.
Hi.
Who would you like to talk to?
Steve Morris.
Now, do you want to answer the trivia question?
Yes.
Okay.
That was Commander Cody.
No, Commander Cody had a later recording of it, probably 10 years later. But that's a good guess.
Okay.
All right, Joyce, have at it.
Okay, what would you be doing if you wasn't playing guitar?
I'd be flying for an airline. In fact, I was a couple years ago as a pilot. And I'm sure that's what I'd be doing next in line.
You mean you were a commercial airline pilot?
Yes, but I couldn't keep up the schedule of trying to do both things, and so I had to resign and go back to music full time.
Who did you fly for?
Well, I don't know if they want that kind of publicity. You know, people are scared about flying, and I shouldn't say, but it was a regional carrier out of Atlanta and Dallas.
Okay, all right. Joyce, thank you for calling.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Let's go to...
Okay.
Hold you.
refer to themselves in derogatory fashion, but in the South, they make up big pots of grits in the morning, and sometimes the stuff at the bottom is called the Dregs or the Dixie Dregs, and that's where the name came from. They're a blend of jazz, rock, country, and classical. They are one of the groups that has been nominated for a Grammy a couple of times because of their daring work. They do not sing, but they allow their instruments to do the talking. Would you please welcome the Dregs? Their album is called Unsung Heroes, and this song is the hit single called Cruise Control. Here are the Dregs. All right.
Thank you.
The Dregs are back now, and I'd like to introduce them by name to all of you. They are Steve Morse, Andy West, Rod Morgenstein, T. Lavitz, and Mark O'Connor. And this is another cut from the album called Dregs of the Earth. This song is called The Old Lamp Lighter. No, it's not. It's called Pride of the Farm. Here again are the Dregs. Gentlemen, take it away. Reservations at Dunphy Hotels in the U.S. and Europe, call toll-free 800-228-2121. Should sex education be...
Concerts at Bonds here in New York.
And that band... And some of these fine musicians... The forthcoming Steve Walsh solo album... And while the Dixie Dregs' music defies description, it definitely is intense and powerful. Tonight, the stellar performances on Night of the Living Dregs with the Dixie Dregs.
Thank you. swing.